Are you a school teacher looking for some ways to add STEM activities to your curriculum? Maybe you're considering something like Arduino, or maybe your school already has some Arduino. Then you're definitely going to want to check out this video about Hyperduino. Hyperduino is an Arduino shield and a whole system that helps introduce second grade through high school students into the fun world of programming and electronics, but it does it in a really interesting way right next to their normal curriculum. By the end of this video, you'll know if Hyperduino is a good fit for your students and your classroom. Stay tuned. Are you trying to learn how to program Arduino? If you want to get a jump start on your skill, you should check out Programming Electronics Academy. We've got a membership program that helps walk you step by step learning how to program Arduino and use it in really interesting ways. If that sounds interesting to you, make sure to check out the link below. So maybe you want to introduce some STEM activities into your classroom, but you're just not sure how to do it at a level that's just right for your students. This is where Hyperduino comes in. What it does is it abstracts away many of the more difficult features of working with Arduino while still allowing your students the excitement of making something interactive. So if you kind of think about the hard stuff of using Arduino, what they've done is they've taken that stuff and they say, yep, let's try to make this as easy as possible for younger people. As you'll see, with the Hyperduino system, you don't need breadboards to make connections. They've got special connectors for all of the different components. They've got ribbon cables set up that make it really easy to connect lots of different things. And you also don't need to program in the Arduino IDE with Arduino code. Instead, you can use pre-made code examples that get loaded onto the Arduino behind the scenes. Or, if you want, you can even use graphical coding tools like mBlock and iForge. Before I jump into the details of using the Hyperduino system, let's quickly talk about the designer of this board. It's a guy named Roger Wagner. So Roger's been in the classroom. He's a former physics, chemistry, biology, and math teacher. He's got some patents under his belt, which is pretty cool. And interestingly, he was named by Technology and Learning magazine one of the 5 most important educational technology gurus of the past 2 decades, along with people like Bill Gates, Steve Wozniak, and Steve Jobs. So, I mean, those are some pretty cool credentials. Now, the reason I bring this up isn't to do a bunch of name dropping. I just want to make the point that a lot of thought has gone into Hyperduino as a tool not only to help students learn how to program and get interested in electronics, but also as a tool for teachers to facilitate that learning. So one recurring theme you'll see on the Hyperduino website is the whole low walls and high ceilings idea. That is, make the barrier to entry for getting into electronics and programming as low as possible, but also give the ability for students to do lots of interesting things with the same platform. Okay, so what exactly is Hyperduino? Well, there's 3 sides to Hyperduino. There's the hardware side, which is essentially an Arduino shield. There is pre-made code examples for the Hyperduino. And then there's also a Chrome web application that can be used to interact with different things, as we'll see. So let's first talk about the Hyperduino Arduino shield. So there's 2 versions of this shield. They've got the Hyperduino and then the Hyperduino plus R, where the R stands for robotics. So the major feature of the Hyperduino shield are 4 large connection ports that go right down the middle of the board. These connect to ribbon cables that come with the Hyperduino kit. 2 sets of the ribbon cables have LEDs pre-attached to the ends. Another ribbon cable comes in single connection points for connecting these included touch sensors, which are basically like little metal tacks. And then there's a final ribbon cable that pairs 2 wires together, and they're meant for connecting analog sensors. For example, a light-dependent resistor, which is also included in the Hyperduino starter kit. So you've also got all the standard Arduino headers around the board, and so you can connect another shield on top of the Hyperduino if you wanted to. There's 4 trimmer potentiometers connected to the analog pins, and these can be adjusted with like a small screwdriver. There's also a place to connect a DC motor, and they've got this place with 3 pins. It's called for experimenting, where they've got 5 volts, ground, and then digital pin 9 kind of routed out, which makes it ideal for playing around with servos. There's also a set of pin headers for connecting an MP3 player module, which comes in a separate audio narration kit. The Hyperduino R has a similar layout. It's a bigger board, and that's because it's got additional connection points for connecting things like stepper motors and DC motors, an additional power port for input for those motors, more trimmer pots, and then for each pin on the Arduino board, it breaks out the pin 5 volts, and ground right next to each other, which seems like a pretty nifty feature. It also has two connectors on the side that are designed to accept the popular groove system of modules. So that's pretty much it on the hardware side of Hyperduino. You can buy additional components from the Hyperduino store, including a robotics kit, which comes with wheeled motors, servos, ultrasonic distance sensors, an IR remote, Bluetooth receiver modules, infrared line following modules, and stuff like that. And all of those modules are made to easily connect to the Hyperduino board or the Hyperduino Plus R board. But Hyperduino is more than just the shield and the hardware. They also have a really interesting Google Chrome web app. And what the app allows you to do is a couple things. The first is it enables you to load code directly onto your Arduino board without using the Arduino IDE. And the way you load the code is that you go to this section where it has programs, and they've got some pre-completed programs for you already. So you don't even have to look at the code per se. You just click on the icon and it will load the code for you. And then each program that you load has a little link where you can go and learn about different activities you can do with the code that gets loaded. So the Hyperduino comes with some examples that you can use right out of the box. And the most prevalent one on the Hyperduino website is being able to turn a poster board project or like a little diorama project into an interactive project by adding touch sensors, LEDs, and even multimedia to the project. So the Hyperduino starter kit comes with everything you need to build a project like this. And it's made in a very accessible way that young people could do this. So it's got ribbon cables that already have the LEDs connected at the end, and those easily plug into the Hyperduino shield. And they've also got ribbon cables where you can connect touch sensors, which are basically just little tacks that fit in the single connector on the end. And that also plugs in easily to the Hyperduino. So just that alone, you can have different touch points and different LEDs come on. And it's pretty neat. You don't need a computer or anything like that. It can just be standalone. But if you want to take it to the next level, you're able to use the Hyperduino Chrome app to link multimedia to different button presses. So maybe you want a portion of a video to play when you press a certain button. Well, you can link it with the app, and it's really pretty straightforward. You highlight the media inside of the app that you want to play. You can designate start and end times. You can say, hey, which button do I want to initiate the playing of the video? And you can have different things occur on the board in addition to the media playing. You can have a servo move or anything like that. Now, the kit comes with a printout example of a volcano poster. I thought it'd be fun to make my own. And I got to say, once I had the web app kind of figured out, it was pretty easy to add stuff. And I can see where having a tool like this in the classroom could make it much easier instead of having like a bunch of little components sitting around and trying to explain to kids, you know, how the rows on the breadboard line up and all that type of stuff. Like, you can work kids into that. But as a starting point, I think this is a great way to introduce them to the whole, like, hey, this is an LED. This is what it means to make a connection and that type of thing. But really, this is just like the beginning project. So you can also use mBlock and iForge, which are graphical programming languages. You can use those to program the Arduino that you've got connected to your Hyperduino. Hyperduino has built modules that work with those programs. So you can play around with the robotics kit, make motors move, make line following robots, and all types of neat stuff like that. So there's lots of room for the students to expand. So as the students get more advanced, you can also jump right into the Arduino IDE and use the Hyperduino shield just like any other Arduino shield. And what it basically does is it breaks out all of those pins for you and makes it pretty simple to use different components. So there's really no limit. It's not like the Hyperduino shield in some way limits your ability to use the different pins. It just makes it easier to kind of connect stuff to it. So just a quick review here. The Hyperduino is the shield. They've got just the basic Hyperduino shield, and then they've got the Hyperduino R. It's also the code examples that they provide for you and kind of the different ideas that go along with those code examples that you could use in the classroom. And then finally, it's the Hyperduino Chrome app that you can use to load code onto the Arduino, to load those code examples, and also to link all different types of media to different projects you might have. Well, if you're a school teacher and you're looking for a way to introduce some STEM projects, STEM kind of stuff into your classroom, I hope that this video has been instructive and, you know, kind of showing you some of the stuff about Hyperduino so you can kind of evaluate it and get an idea if it's going to be a good fit for your classroom. Thanks a ton for watching this video, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.